Al Bernardo and his wife, Carla Homolka, led to outsiders what seemed to be a normal life. The couple was the quintessential beautiful couple, with their matching beach blonde hair, blue eyes, and seemingly perfect complexions. But underneath their perfection lay secrets. Secrets that would lead to them being forever known as the Ken and Barbie killers. By the end of their crime streak in the late 80s and early 90s, the couple was responsible for at least 13 rapes and potentially up to 4 murders. This is a brief history of the Ken and Barbie killers. As always, this episode of A Brief History contains graphic content that may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised. Paul Bernardo was born on August 27, 1964, to parents Kenneth and Marilyn Bernardo. The Bernardos were a wealthy family, but held on to dark secrets that would shape Paul's childhood and subsequently his life. Kenneth Bernardo was said to be exceptionally abusive to the family, despite also being known to tolerate an affair that Marilyn had been having that brings Paul's paternity into question. When Paul was 10 years old, his father, Kenneth, was accused of fondling a young girl and was charged with child molestation. It is also believed that he sexually abused his own daughter, Paul's sister. Marilyn, tired of the abuse, entered a depressive state and withdrew from her husband and children, eventually living out of the basement in the family home. But Paul, as a young child, seemed unaffected by the horrors he faced on a daily basis with his siblings, and was said to be someone who was always happy and smiling. Paul learned of his true parentage after an argument with his mother at the age of 16, and took a turn. From then, he would openly refer to his mother as a whore, and his change in views about his mother seemed to extend onto his views of other women as well. Paul was eventually accepted to the University of Toronto, Scarborough, and was known to enjoy humiliating women in public, and frequently physically abused the women he was dating. On May 4th, 1987, Paul Bernardo's need to tyrannize women would come to a head. Bernardo followed home a 21-year-old woman and raped her in front of her parents' house, with the act lasting more than 30 minutes. Just 10 days later, Bernardo attacked another woman, this time a 19-year-old in the backyard of her parents' home. This time, the act lasted over an hour. Then, 2 months later, at the end of July 1987, Bernardo attempted to attack another woman, but gave up when she began fighting back. Bernardo felt defeated by his failed attempt and seemed to abandon his need for dominance for at least a little while. Then, in October of 1987, a 23-year-old Paul Bernardo met 17-year-old Carla Homolka. Carla was born on May 4th, 1970, to parents Carol and Dorothy Homolka. Carla led what people claimed to be a very normal life with loving parents. As she aged, she was known to be exceptionally pretty, smart, and very popular among her peers. But Carla, like Paul, had secrets underneath her Barbie perfect facade. Paul found that not only was Carla interested in S&M, but she actively encouraged Paul's own sick fantasies and crimes. It's been said that Carla was aware that Paul was the Scarborough rapist and approved of his crimes. The pair entered into a master-slave relationship, with Paul being the master and Carla submitting to his every fantasy. The pair were engaged after being together for 3 years, and during that time, Paul continued his serial rapes across Scarborough, attacking at least 14 more women, leading to him being known as the Scarborough Rapist. In a few of the cases, the victims fought back and ended up scaring Paul off. And in others, Paul was nearly caught by officers who happened upon Paul stalking women or generally acting suspicious, but he was not caught. Around the time of their engagement, Paul began to get bored with Carla and complained frequently about her not having been a virgin when they met. Paul became interested in Carla's 15-year-old sister, Tammy, and being the sick individual that she was, Carla approved and vowed to present her younger sister's virginity to her fiancé as a twisted Christmas gift. 2 days prior to Christmas in 1990, Paul and Carla decided to lay their trap for the young Tammy Homolka. Carla had stolen anesthetics from the vet clinic she worked at, and spiked her sister's drink with them at the tail end of a party at the Homolka family home. After the family went to sleep and Tammy had been rendered unconscious from the anesthetics, Paul and Carla videotaped themselves taking turns raping the young girl, but things didn't continue as planned. Tammy began choking up vomit, and both Paul and Carla panicked, desperate to cover up any evidence of their wrongdoing before calling for help. They wasted precious time hiding the video camera and repositioning Tammy to make it seem like she had succumbed to alcohol poisoning before calling an ambulance. Tammy was pronounced dead at the hospital and the drugs in her system were never detected, ruling her death an accident. Unperturbed by the death of Tammy Homolka, Paul and Carla only escalated their behaviors. Carla befriended young girls to lure them in for her fiancé, with the couple videotaping their escapades after drugging their victims. On June 15, 1991, the couple kidnapped 14-year-old Leslie Mahaffey and abused and tortured her over the course of several days before strapping concrete blocks to her body and dumping her into Lake Gibson, again videotaping the entire ordeal. The body was discovered by canoers on June 29, 1991, the same day Paul and Carla finally married. Nearly a year later, the couple kidnapped another young girl, 15-year-old Kristen French, who was walking back to her house from her nearby Catholic school. Carla distracted the girl by asking her for directions, while Paul attacked French from behind and dragged her into the front seat of the car. Paul and Carla abused and tortured French for a full weekend, keeping her drugged and drunk so she would remain submissive to the couple. The couple murdered the young girl just prior to leaving for Easter dinner at the Homolka family home. Kristen French was dumped nude on the side of the road in Burlington, Ontario. Over the years of their criminal activity, both Paul and Carla were questioned by police in relation to the Scarborough rapist investigation. Some of the victims had compiled enough information for an accurate police sketch of Bernardo, and coupled with the death of Tammy Homolka and Bernardo's history of stalking women, it seemed impossible that the couple was not connected in some way to the rapes and subsequent murders in the area. During the investigation, Carla ended up leaving Paul after a violent incident of him beating her with a flashlight. Soon after, DNA evidence taken from Bernardo was shown to be a match for the Scarborough rapist. Paul Bernardo was then put under surveillance and eventually arrested in February of 1993. Knowing that she would be connected to the crimes, Carla Homolka lawyered up and asked for a plea bargain in exchange for testifying against her abusive husband. Carla downplayed her own role in the crimes and instead sought to place all of the blame on Paul, which worked for a while. The Canadian government offered her a plea deal of just 12 years in prison for her cooperation, but then, during the trial, the videotapes the couple had made of their crimes were released, and it was proven that Carla wasn't as innocent as she let authorities believe. Still, she had provided sufficient information to the government, and they did not reopen her case to attempt for higher punishment. In 1995, Paul Bernardo was tried for the murders of Kristen French and Leslie Mahaffey, as well as numerous aggravated sexual assaults. Paul was found guilty and sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole for at least 25 years. Paul is also designated a dangerous offender, which fortunately makes it unlikely that he will ever be released. In the years he's been incarcerated, Paul Bernardo has had to be kept separate from the general population of inmates due to the nature of his crimes. He has been harassed and attacked by other inmates many, many times while in prison, and was eventually transferred from Kingston Penitentiary to Millhaven Institution to separate him further. Paul Bernardo has applied for parole in 2006, but was denied. He applied again for day parole in 2015 and was denied again. It is reported that it is extremely unlikely that he will ever be released due to his dangerous offender status, and he does remain incarcerated to this day. Carla, on the other hand, was released in 2005 and has since remarried and had a son with her new husband. As of January 2020, it was reported that Carla Homolka lives in Quebec without her husband or her son, but nothing else is known about her. The Ken and Barbie killers were known for both their good looks and their brutal crimes. They have been portrayed in pop culture and true crime podcasts, videos, and shows many times since their arrests, including the film Carla, starring That 70s Show Laura Prepon as Carla, and Supernatural's Nisha Collins as Paul. Carla's release from prison is still fiercely debated today, and is a sensitive issue due to the nature of her crimes. Paul Bernardo will seemingly rot in prison for the rest of his days. Thank you for joining me for this episode of A Brief History. Thank you to my patrons who support this series every month. You are so appreciated. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to like and subscribe for more true crime Sims content every Friday. Stay safe, and I'll see you next time.